Spanish flu or influenza of 1918 has reared its ugly head in Knox County, Indiana on this date of October 6, 1918. Decker, Indiana. Elmer Glenn's entire family has the flu, including his wife, and four children, are suffering from the epidemic in a mild form. Arthur Kane and children also are suffering from the influenza. Dr. R.C. Davis is a victim of the flu. Under orders issued by Dr. Reeves of Edwardsport, County Board of Health Secretary, all schools, churches, and places for public gatherings must close today and remain closed. As of October 10, 1918, Dr. J.L. Reeves of Edwardsport, Indiana advised close all schools, churches, and places of public amusement, and forbid all public meetings in your county until further notice on account of epidemic influenza, signed by order of the State Board of Health. Dr. J.N. Hurdy, Secretary. Drive N.E. Beck, Secretary of the City Board of Health, gave this order to the City of Vincennes this afternoon at 2 o'clock. School Superintendent of Schools J.W. Foreman attended a conference with Dr. Beck and Mayor McDowell. Schools were closed until new orders. All 8 schools were closed until further notice. Under the order, the city's pool rooms will remain open because of their tobacco sales, the tables cannot be used. Ice cream parlors can remain open, but it's like they will have to close under new orders. 5 to 10 cases per 1,000 of population constitutes an epidemic. Public funerals permitted if dead body is embalmed. No danger from an embalmed dead body. Danger is in public, spitter, coughers, and sneezers. Dr. Beck stated there were several cases of the old la grippe in the city, but they were mild, and could not be termed influenza. He said in all likelihood there will be several cases appear in the city before the week is up. The 5 movie picture houses of the city are hard hit by the closings. They had films booked far in advance, and it's not known if they can cancel. Superintendent Foreman advised that the closing of the schools also meant the night schools too. Spanish influenza, what it is, and how it should be treated. Headlines read in the Sun commercial October 13, 1918. Nothing new, simply the old grip, or la grip that was epidemic in 1889 to 1990, only then it came from Russia by way of France, and this time by way of Spain. Go to bed, and stay quiet, take a laxative, eat plenty of nourishing food, and keep up your strength. Nature is the cure. Of course, always call the doctor. No occasion for panic, the paper said. Spanish influenza appeared in Spain in May, the grip. Or la grip, which has swept over the world in numerous epidemics as far back as history runs. Every century has had its attacks. Beginning with 1831, this country has had 5 epidemics, the last in 1889 to 1890. No occasion for panic, influenza itself has a very low percentage of fatalities, not over 1 death out of every 400 cases according to the NC Board of Health. The chief dangers lies in complications arising, attacking principally, patients in a run-down condition, those who don't go to bed soon enough, or those who get up too early. The symptoms, grip, or influenza as it is now called, usually begins with a chill, followed by aching, feverishness and sometimes nausea and dizziness, and a general feeling of weakness and depression. The temperature is from 100 to 104, and the fever usually lasts from 3 to 5 days. The germs attack the mucous membranes or lining of the air passages, nose, throat, and bronchial tubes. There is usually a hard cough, especially bad at night, oftentimes a sore throat or tonsillitis, and may look like a severe cold. The treatment, go to bed at first symptoms, not only for your own sake, but to avoid spreading the disease to others. Take a purgative, eat plenty of nourishing food. Remain quiet and don't worry. Quinine, aspirin or Dover's Power, may be administered by physician's direction to relieve the aching, but there is no cure. Influenza so weakens the bodily resistance that it may cause pneumonia or bronchitis. Stay in bed 2 days or more after the fever has left you, or if you're over 50 or not strong, stay in bed 4 days more, according to severity of the attack. External applications in order to stimulate the lining of the air passages to throw off the grip. Vicks VapoRub will be effective to help breathe easier. Hot wet towels should be applied over the throat, chest, and back between the shoulder blades. VapoRub should be rubbed in over the parts until the skin is red, and spread on thickly. These vapors inhaled with each breath carry the medication directly to the affected parts. How to avoid the disease? Avoid persons having colds, which means avoiding crowds, common drinking cups, roller towels. Keep up your bodily strength by plenty of exercise in the open air, and good food. Use Vicks VapoRub at first sign of a cold. Seriously ill with the flu, was reported in the paper on October 17, 1918. George Cadavdekar, a prominent young man, in serious condition as a result of attack by epidemic. A prominent young man of Decker, well known over Knox County, is in serious condition as a result of being stricken with the Spanish influenza. Two physicians were called and announced that young Cat is suffering from the genuine epidemic. Greatest precautions are being taken to prevent a further spread of the epidemic. Notwithstanding this precaution, the epidemic continues to spread in Decker, and several persons are reported to be suffering from the influenza, although in most cases the attack is light. There is some question as to whether or not the schools will open next Monday, even though the federal ban has been lifted. It seems that in Knox County the epidemic has started in Decker. So far several Knox County families have service members suffering from the Spanish flu abroad and in the States. Friday, October 18, 1918, funerals must be private, written in the headlines in the Sun commercial today. Secretary City Board of Health serves notice that federal order must be strictly observed. All funerals regardless of the cause of death, must be strictly private. Dr. N. E. Beckus, Secretary of the City Board of Health, issued a statement last night to the effect that no infringements on the federal order placing a ban on all kinds of public gatherings will not be tolerated, and that the order will be enforced rigidly up until the last minute of the existence of the ban. Whether it be at midnight on the night of October 20th, or at midnight on the night of October 27th. It is not the danger of contracting the epidemic from a person who dies with influenza that necessitates the enforcement of the order, for all contagious disease germs are killed when a patient is embalmed. But it is to prevent people from congregating in crowds in which some person with influenza might mingle with other people, thus spreading the epidemic. Ban continues until October the 26th. The Vincennes commercial read on October 19, 1918. State Board of Health orders influenza ban to continue in full force until next Saturday, situation is serious. In Vincennes the order of the State Board of Health extending the influenza ban until midnight of October 26th was not unexpected, and the authorities here had made no arrangements for reopening the schools, or removing the ban on the moving picture shows, or other public gatherings. Several new cases of influenza were reported to Dr. N. E. Becca, Secretary of the City Board of Health, Friday evening. All cases reported were mild, and with proper attention both on the part of the physicians, and the patients there is no cause for anxiety. However, it is necessary to exercise the greatest amount of precaution, in order to prevent any spread of the epidemic in Vincennes. On some personal notes from the Vincennes commercial, Miss Pearl Howell of Valley Mills, Indiana is in the city visiting Mrs. Jake Riddle, who is recovering from an attack of the Spanish flu. Well, I figure if Valley Mills, Indiana doesn't have a case of the Spanish flu, it soon will have. Death caused by pneumonia, Lee H. Johnson passed away Sunday morning. After a brief illness of pneumonia, recovering from influenza. Lee H. Johnson, aged 39 years old, well-known carpenter who returned home from Camp Knox, Kentucky the latter part of last week to recuperate from the attack of influenza. Passed away at his home, 1318 Shelby Street, Sunday morning after a brief illness of pneumonia. Thursday, October 24, 1918, the commercial headlines read, "Extend ban for another week." Present indications are that influenza ban will not be lifted in Vincennes Saturday, several new cases. Condition is such that should the ban be lifted the danger of the epidemic being widespread would be greatly increased. Physicians announced last night that it would be a very serious matter at the present time to permit the reopening of the city schools as number of cases of influenza in Vincennes warrant the schools remaining closed until conditions show a marked improvement. Number of deaths from the disease have been very few in the city, there are many sick that are threatening serious developments. One died last Wednesday afternoon. One physician reported that he has several cases where more than one member of the family are afflicted with the influenza. There is more cause now for the schools remaining closed than at any time during the last 3 weeks. When the schools were ordered closed, there were very few cases, than they are now. It was reported that most cases are mild, but complications develop in the second week is noticed. Patients must exercise the greatest possible care in order to avoid the danger of developing pneumonia or other complications. Reports from the State Board of Health indicate that the state ban may be extended for an indefinite period of time. Some improvements in the northern part of the state are noted. The epidemic is raging in some of the southern counties, and many deaths being reported. J.W. Foreman, City Superintendent of Schools, stated last night that even though the state ban might be lifted Saturday, there was but little probability of reopening the city schools Monday. As to do so would greatly increase the danger of the epidemic becoming widespread. How to use Vicks VapoRub in the treating Spanish influenza. The influenza germs attack the lining of the air passages when VapoRub is applied over throat and chest. The medicated vapors loosen the phlegm, open the air passages, and stimulate the mucous membrane to throw off the germs. VapoRub was one of the best and most important medication they had in 1918. The pharmacies had trouble keeping it stocked. I wonder how it would work with the coronavirus COVID-19. As of October 26, 1918, the health board extends ban until November 2. New York Mayor Hyland tonight called on the officials of the five boroughs of New York to provide laborers equipped with picks and shovels to help bury the dead, the cemeteries can't keep up. The city health authorities are discussing the question of ordering everyone outside their homes to wear a gauze mask as a preventive measures against the spreading of influenza. Other cities have already ordered to wear mask. On a personal note, it's been reported that Theodore L. Duisterberg passed away at home at 314 Church Street Friday, October 25, 1918 at 5:25 a.m., death caused by pneumonia, he was only 33 years old. He was known to his friends as Dix. Funeral services will be at his home tomorrow at 3 p.m., and will be private in compliance with the influenza ban. He had been working as a traveling salesman. I assume traveling from town to town and door to door had not been banned yet. The situation in Bicknell, notwithstanding close observance of ban order, influenza epidemic continues to spread. Thus far, three deaths have occurred, but in several instances complications have developed, and more deaths are feared. Everything possible is being done to check the spread of the epidemic. While no quarantine has been established, the ban rules are so rigid and are completely enforced that there appears no cause for the spreading of the epidemic, but the influenza has made its appearance in several new homes, and several of the members of a family have been stricken in many of these places. Flu ban is to be lifted, the headlines in the Vincennes commercial read. Ban to be raised Saturday night at midnight, providing order is issued by the State Board of Health, removing the ban in Indiana counties. This is the information given the commercial last night. Dr. H.W. Held, newly appointed Secretary of the City Board of Health. Dr. Held stated, every precaution will be taken to safeguard against danger of recurrence of any epidemic. School superintendents and teachers have pledged to cooperate with the health officers, and to send home any children showing indications of being afflicted with influenza. Homes will be marked where there are cases of influenza. The managers of the moving picture houses will take every precaution to make their theaters safe. An emergency flu hospital, the headlines read. The Eagles home at Bicknell has been turned over to the Knox County chapter of the American Red Cross, an emergency hospital under the supervision of Miss Edith Willis, with an equipment of 18 beds, will be immediately installed, and will be operated by the Red Cross. The influenza situation in Bicknell increases with seriousness. Numerous new cases have been reported, an effort is being made to check the spread of the disease, and prevent further deaths. Today Bicknell has reported 5 deaths from the disease. On November Thursday 7, 1918, headlines read influenza caused death. Mrs. Clarence Plass of Near Decker, died Wednesday afternoon following attack of influenza. Mrs. Clarence Ingram, residing on the Plass farm, 2 miles north of Decker, passed away this afternoon at 2 p.m. Influenza was the cause of her death. She was aged 40 years, and is survived by her husband and child. Her death was the first death from influenza in that area. Ban is placed on Iona schools again, a story in the Vincennes Commercial read, on November 7, 1918. The ban, which was lifted from schools and public meetings, was again placed on the Iona school today. New cases of the influenza is the cause reported for the action of the health authorities. The ban will remain in force until danger of the epidemic has passed. Family has influenza as reported to the Vincennes Commercial, on November 9, 1918. Mrs. Neely Decker, living south of the city, is seriously ill with influenza and pneumonia. Her daughter Mrs. Florence Catt, who's came to care for her mother, has influenza and pneumonia. Mrs. Decker's son Roy, and grandson Carl also have the influenza. Dr. Abel of St. Francisville is attending them. Sunday, November 10, 1918, the Vincennes Commercial reported, not to place flu ban. According to a statement last night by Dr. H.W. Held, Secretary of the City Board of Health, the influenza ban will not be placed again on the city at the present time. If the situation doesn't get more serious, the ban may remain lifted. There are numerous cases of influenza in the city, it was stated, but nature of these cases is not such as to cause alarm. Persons with symptoms of the influenza are urged to remain at home. The situation in Vincennes, according to Dr. Held, has not been serious at any time. November 10, 1918, the Vincennes Commercial reported on a Bicknell family. The headlines read, in throes of flu epidemic. Bicknell family experiencing heart-rending, realities of seriousness of the influenza epidemic. Bicknell is rapidly coming to the realization that the influenza is something not to be looked upon lightly. 8 deaths have occurred here of influenza this week. Today, Lemon and Wampler undertakers buried 4 bodies, and have 5 more funerals to hold. The family of Elmer Hanks presents one of the most pitiful illustrations of the seriousness of the situation here, and reveals a story of misfortune dating back from early last summer. Mr. Hanks is a highly respected citizen, and by thrift and energy had succeeded in saving a sufficient sum to purchase 2 lots in Johnstown south of the city. They intended building a home on 1 lot, and a small building. The frame of the dwelling had been erected, but the work on the building was stopped by sickness which visited the family. Percy Hanks, aged 16 years, was stricken with typhoid, and his condition was serious for a time. He recovered, but about that his mother was stricken with blood poisoning, and for a time it was feared she would die. Then came the influenza epidemic, and the entire family was stricken. The family was living in the barn, and the health authorities in Bicknell, learning of the manner in which they were living, decided to bring the sick children to Bicknell, and place them in the emergency hospital in the Elks House. This morning the ambulance was sent to Johnstown to bring the family to the hospital. Arriving there, it was found that Flossie Hanks, age 14, her condition was so serious that she could not be moved. Percy, aged 12, and the twin daughters, aged 10 years, was placed in the ambulance, and brought to the city. The family was taken into the hospital when the news came that Flossie had died. The situation in Bicknell was so bad, the Board of Health extended the ban for indefinite amount of time. November 13, 1918, the Vincennes Commercial reported at Sandbourne 17 cases of influenza, and ban on public gatherings has been placed. The Spanish flu has finally came to Sandbourne, Indiana. A total of 17 persons has contracted the disease since Saturday. None of the cases have proved fatal. Steps were immediately taken by the local health board to prevent the spread of the disease. All public gatherings, including schools and churches, are prohibited for an indefinite time. More nurses needed, read in the Vincennes Commercial November 13, 1918. Influenza situation in Vincennes, taxes resources of the Red Cross to supply sufficient number of nurses. Dr. Held, Secretary of the City Board of Health, is accredited with a statement that there have been no new cases of influenza in Vincennes for several days. The situation in the city has become such that an appeal was made last night by the Red Cross for nurses to take care of some of the more serious cases, which have developed into pneumonia. An appeal was made to the local hospital to supply a nurse for one case where the entire family is ill, but it was impossible to do so. The city, Red Cross, and doctors are appealing for nurses. No one is able to secure a sufficient number to care for the more serious cases. Nurses are needed, and needed badly. Vincennes Health Board puts on ban at midnight tonight, November 14, 1918. The serious spread of influenza cases makes it necessary for the City Board of Health to again place the ban on Vincennes. Dr. Held communicates with the State Board. The ban will affect the city schools, churches, and all places where the crowds congregate. Anything that will have a tendency to increase the crowds in stores will be prohibited, and the number of persons permitted in a store at one time is limited. The ban will remain in force until the danger of further spread of the epidemic has passed. While there has been no fatalities from the influenza in Vincennes this month, physicians reported that several patients are very ill. The rapid manner in which the epidemic is spreading is cause for serious concern. In order to better care for the patients and provide nurses, an emergency hospital will be opened in the Bishop Home, formerly occupied by Jake Jimble. This hospital will be under the supervision of the Red Cross. Decker game postponed, headlines in the Commercial on November 16, 1918. Influenza ban throughout county, occasion for cancelling basketball game at Decker tonight. Vincennes, Decker basketball game scheduled to be played at Decker tonight has been postponed, this action being necessary because of the influenza ban which is now in force throughout the entire county. The Vincennes High School team went to Sullivan for the opening game of the season last night, and intended going to Decker tonight, but when the announcement that the influenza ban had been made county-wide, and the Decker game was cancelled, and will be played in a later date. Take drastic steps to wipe out influenza epidemic in Vincennes, the Vincennes Commercial reported on November 17, 1918. Order issued by Secretary of Board of Health, that all homes in which influenza exists be placarded and cases isolated, and that physicians attending influenza cases make daily reports to the Secretary of the Board of Health, many new cases reported Saturday. The letter submitted by the Council of Defense to Dr. Held is as follows: Dr. Held, Secretary, City Board of Health, Vincennes, Indiana. Dear Sir, it seems to be the general opinion of the businessmen and the residents of Vincennes that a quarantine be established in every case of influenza. This matter has been fully discussed by the Red Cross Executive Committee and the Executive Committee of the Chamber of Commerce, and an appeal made to us to take such action as is deemed necessary for the protection of the people. We therefore earnestly recommend to you that such quarantine be immediately established, and a full public statement printed in the press on the subject. We recommend that you give such orders as are necessary in the premises to the end that the physicians of the city may post placards, and give this protection the widest possible publicity. We trust you are in sympathy with this movement, and will aid the movement by giving your hearty cooperation. Yours truly, Knox County Council of Defense. Thomas H. Adams, Chairman. The Executive Committee has made a request for another emergency hospital be opened in order to care for any additional cases which may need to be taken to a hospital. The Masonic Temple has been generously donated for this purpose, and beds and equipment will be immediately installed. The health authorities continue to urge the citizens exert the greatest possible degree of precaution in order to prevent spreading the epidemic. Also, the Commercial reported on November 17, 1918, the situation in Sandbourne is becoming extremely critical, according to a communication from that city Saturday afternoon, obtained by the Red Cross organization. The epidemic is raging in Sandbourne, and that city is left with only one physician to handle the situation. A physician will be sent from Vincennes to investigate, and an effort will be made to render assistance. In Bicknell, according to reports, there is practically no change in the situation, notwithstanding the drastic efforts of the new Board of Health to wipe out the epidemic. Reports from Wheatland and Decker are to the effect that the situation in those towns shows but little indication of improvement. Sad news was reported from the Commercial on November 17, 1918. Mrs. Victor G. Klein passed away Saturday morning of pneumonia, following attack of influenza. Passed away at her home at 111 Hart Street. Saturday morning at 11:30 a.m. The condition of the patient's heart hastened the end, according to a statement by the physicians. The deceased is survived by her husband, Victor Klein, shipping clerk at the National Rolling Mills. The family have been residents of the city for about 1 year. The remains were taken to Evansville for burial, leaving here at 12:25 a.m. this morning. The death of Mrs. Klein was the second death to occur from the recent epidemic of influenza. Don't be too optimistic yet, warns the Vincennes Commercial. Says the City Board of Health when asked concerning influenza conditions in the city. Ban is still on for some time. New cases, and two more deaths have been reported in the last 24 hours to Secretary. Conditions are not improved today. Two deaths, and every doctor has several new cases. These were the outstanding features of the daily report of the City Board of Health on the influenza conditions in the city. There have been two deaths in the 24 hours, and a number of new cases reported to the Board of Health. The conditions are not improving as rapidly as the Health Board would like to see it, and unless they are a great deal better, and show more signs of improvement, the chance for the ban to be lifted is not encouraging. Dr. H.W. Held, the secretary, would not give a date when he thought the ban would be lifted, but did make the statement that there was no chance this week at all. The calling together of schools will not be considered, it is understood, until the health board raises the ban in the city. Sad news today reported in the Commercial today on November 19, 1918. Death was very sudden. Mrs. Mabel Admire, school teacher, passed away on Monday morning, death resulting from influenza. Mrs. Mabel Elberman Admire, aged 37 years, one of the popular teachers at public school at 15th and Main Streets, passed away Monday morning at 1:30 a.m. at her home at 1211 Main Street. Influenza was the cause of her death. Mrs. Admire had been seriously ill with influenza for the past 2 weeks, but was recovering. She was considerably improved Sunday, and was feeling better Sunday night. Shortly after midnight she suffered a sudden attack with her heart, and passed away in a short time. She is survived by her husband James Admire, conductor on the Vandalia Railroad. The remains will be shipped to Spencer, her former home, this morning at 6:25 a.m., and interment will be made in that city. November 19, 1918, it's reported that nurse has influenza. Miss Margaret Davidson, a trained nurse who was in charge of the emergency hospital, opened last Wednesday afternoon, in the Bishop home on Church Street, is confined to her bed at the home of her mother, suffering from a light attack of influenza. Miss Davidson, who is a registered nurse, is preparing to enter the Red Cross service as a nurse, and is expecting to leave about the 1st of December. Her condition is not serious, according to reports late last night. Also in the same paper it was reported that Mrs. Hannah Wall and her little son are recovering from a serious attack of influenza. Sad funeral held today, reported by the Vincennes Commercial today on Wednesday, November 20, 1918. Widow and daughter of the late James Baldridge, sick with influenza, view remains of husband and father from their bed. The funeral services of the late James H. Baldridge were conducted from the home of his sister, Mrs. Robert Watson, on Dubois Street at 2 p.m. Tuesday afternoon, Reverend Holmes officiated. The death and funeral of Mr. Baldridge was especially sad. For some time past he had been ill with dropsy at his home, 1614 Wheeler Street, but last week his wife and daughter took sick with the influenza, and as Mrs. Baldridge was obliged to take to her bed, her husband on Saturday was removed to the home of his sister, Mrs. Watson, where he passed away Sunday afternoon. On Tuesday afternoon, Following the funeral services at the Watson home, the remains were taken to the home of the deceased where the bereaved widow and daughter were permitted to take a last view of the deceased husband and father from their beds. The remains were then taken to the city cemetery nearby, where they were laid to rest. The deceased was aged 43 years, and was held in high esteem by all who knew him. For a number of years prior to taking sick with his fatal illness, he was employed as an order clerk at Beer House Brothers Wholesale Grocery. He is survived by his widow Flora, and two children Leora and James Jr., who are confined to their beds with influenza, his mother Mrs. Mary A. Baldridge, two sisters, Mrs. Robert Watson, and Mrs. Linny McMullen, and one brother, William Baldridge, all of this city. Heroic fight to save life was made by friends of Walter Scott, of Bicknell, but efforts were of no avail, died midnight. Headlines in the Vincennes commercial on November 20, 1918, read today. Despite the heroic fight made by the friends of Walter Scott to save his life, the efforts were of no avail, other than to postpone for a few hours the end, and he passed away at midnight at the emergency hospital. Death was due to complications resulting from influenza. About 3 weeks he was taken ill with the influenza, but at times it was thought that danger from complications had passed. Following the victory celebration last Monday night, Mr. Scott's condition became alarming, and Monday the physician attending announced that there was but little hope. Mr. Scott was chief of the mine rescue and first aid station, and his friends and fellow workers, after securing consent of the physician, began their fight against death, resorting to the use of the pulmotor. Life was prolonged for 8 hours by this method, although the patient remained unconscious during the entire time. Death relieved his sufferings at midnight Monday night. The body was sent to the former home of the deceased at Harrisburg, Illinois, Tuesday afternoon, where interment will be made. Also on November 20, 1918, the commercial reported that Sanborn reports about 100 cases of influenza, all cases having developed during past week. The epidemic of influenza in and about Sanborn is still very serious. About 100 cases have come to the local health officer Dr. E.W. Johnson. 2 weeks ago there was not a single case in the community. Every precaution is being taken to prevent the spread of the disease. Monday's report was encouraging in that all new cases reported that day were in families where the disease had already appeared. November 20, 1918 in the commercial today, another victim of the influenza. The paper today, when Mrs. Victor Klein, 111 Hart Street, passed away at the family residence at 1:30 a.m. this morning, following an illness 4 or 5 days. Mrs. Klein has been confined to her bed, but for the past few days, and the case has been one of gradual decline. She was first stricken with influenza, which gradually turned to double pneumonia, her death this morning being the result. The deceased leaves to survive a husband, Victor Klein, shipping clerk at the National Rolling Mills. The family came to the city to make it their home about a year ago. To make masks for merchants, in the paper today on November 22, 1918. North End Red Cross will make influenza masks to be worn by merchants and clerks in stores. With the object in view of checking the influenza epidemic with as much speed as possible, the Red Cross of North Vincennes has decided upon a policy which it is hoped will bring about the desired results. A meeting of the members of the North Vincennes Red Cross Society is called for this afternoon in the KFP building for the purpose of making influenza masks. The masks made by the Red Cross will be worn by all the merchants in the North End, and by the clerks in the stores and shops as well. Maurice Hoffman, cashier of the Wabash Bank and secretary of the North Vincennes Red Cross Society, announced last night that all the employees of the bank would begin wearing influenza masks. Mr. Hoffman stated that in all probability other banks would be called upon to take similar action. Influenza has been raging in North Vincennes for several days, the epidemic making its appearance in this part of the city first, and in order to get the situation under control as rapidly as possible, the businessmen have decided upon trying out the influenza masks which are being worn in Indianapolis and other cities where similar epidemics are holding away.